So Vortex Fog is a new product that we have introduced with Vortex 2.0, which is intended to simplify the deployment and the development of fog-based systems. So in that respect, Vortex Fog allows you to very easily identify the boundaries of a fog subsystem, ensure that you can decouple the protocols and security concerns that you have within the fog subsystem with respect to the protocols and the security concerns that you might have outside of the fog subsystem. It also allows you to do QoS adaptation and any other kind of data flow adaptation that typically are required because the dynamics that you have within a fog subsystem, and the dynamics in terms of bandwidth and potentially asymmetry that you might have in your system when communicating and sharing data across the fog toward the cloud or other fog, have to be taken into account, and that impedance mismatch has to be, let's say, dealt with. And that is really the role of fog. So all of a sudden, just by deploying fog in a completely transparent manner for your end system, you can expose the data securely to other subsystem, control how this data is transiting, which protocol are used, and how this data is being secured. The underlying technology that underpins Vortex Cloud and Vortex Fog is essentially the same, which is good, because essentially it ensures that you build on top of a very solid base. But the use cases and the deployment style for the two technologies is very different. So Vortex Cloud is a cloud messaging implementation of the DDS protocol, and that is typically deployed in a cloud infrastructure. What you care in that context is scale out, management of a lot of instances of what we call our routing and discovery service, and so on and so forth. If you look at the deployment of Vortex Fog, Vortex Fog is typically deployed on the edge. You typically deploy in a multi-protocol environment, so usually you will have a multicast inside your subsystem and some form of, let's say, unicast, could be UDP or TCP, to communicate with the rest of the world. And the deployment with respect to, you know, how many instances or the elasticity, as well as some of the QoS adaptation properties, are different just because of the way in which you deploy the two different technologies. So the point is that there are two different products, Vortex Cloud and Vortex Fog, because they address different use cases, different deployment style, and we have made it simpler for you actually to wrap an entire subsystem behind the Fog subsystem by just transparently deploying Vortex Fog and making Vortex Fog as simple as possible to configure. On the other hand, the deployment of a Vortex Cloud, it addresses a slightly different problem, because all of a sudden you want to have a cloud messaging architecture that has to scale out. You have to decide, you know, which load balancing policy you want to choose, and so on and so forth. So whilst the underlying technology at the very heart is the same, the use cases are very different, the way in which you deploy are different, and the way in which you configure the system is slightly different. And in fact, arguably, Vortex Fog, as you will see, it's simpler to configure than Vortex Cloud, because your design space and the variability is more constrained. Well, there are plenty of reasons why you want to use Vortex. The first and foremost reason is abstraction. Abstraction, it's what gains us, obviously, time, productivity, and what limits the human errors. Okay? Because the more you operate in an abstract and high level, the less you are concerned with details that cribble in and eventually, you know, make you do silly things. So what is the abstraction that Vortex provides that is so important in IoT? Well, there is data distribution as opposed to just pipes or queues or messages. So all of a sudden you can express entities that make sense in your application domain, like a car position, like a heartbeat, or anything that makes sense in your business domain, and share this business entity as opposed to having to scratch your head and think, okay, well, my application is about medical devices, and this is the data that a medical device provides. How am I going to format this data and send it through messages so that I can share that? So those are details that you shouldn't really be bothered with. You should just raise the abstraction barrier, think about the data that matters in your system and use a technology that allows you to do that, and that's Vortex. The second reason is that to really implement this elegant abstraction of data sharing, we have this very powerful internet-scale dynamic discovery that ensures that the abstraction is not leaky. In the sense, your data sharing feels and looks the same whether you're sharing data with application on the same network, on the same machine, or across the globe, while at the same time ensuring that depending on the distribution of the devices or application interested in receiving your data, at any level in your system and throughout your system, the distribution will be optimized by leveraging the peculiarities of the network. Our role and mission is that of making data available where it's needed in the most effective manner possible, while taking advantage of the infrastructure that is provided throughout this distribution chain. So if you think for a moment about fog computing, very often in a fog subsystem, you have the necessity of very efficiently exchanging data, taking advantage of the network peculiarities. So for instance, on a fog subsystem, you might be able to exploit multicast. So Vortex will allow you to take advantage of that to minimize latency, throughput, and ensure that you have an architecture that is more fault resilient, because all of a sudden you don't have any infrastructure or any single point of failure that you can pinpoint, take down, and all of a sudden the infrastructure doesn't work anymore. But likewise, Vortex provides you with this data fabric that at any point in your system, from the fog or across fog, or from the fog to a cloud and yet to a device that might be communicating with fog from the cloud, allows you to just forget the details about connectivity, forget about details concerning networking technology, and just focus on data. Focus on the data that matters to you, and then we'll just make the job to ensure that this data will be distributed and shared in the most effective manner as permitted by the current network connectivity and network topology. So, you want to learn more about fog computing? Well, obviously, a very good place to start is our website, but in that case, you should download our software, so Vortex for our website, look after the Open Fog Consortium, follow our fog computing blog that we have recently started, and follow us on the various social media, seeing interesting that might come on this subject.